Fundamentals of Software Testing, Real Life Problems. Yeah, the course is about end, but here is some interesting scenarios from real life. In paper testing always happens in a testing environment. There are probably real data or fake data, but it's still the environment is so that there are no real users at the same time when the testing is happening. But what if there is no testing environment at all? One could always argument that then something has been designed wrongly. There should be a testing environment. Yeah, there should be, but there are cases that you cannot have testing environments. So how would you test the software when all the relevant data is in a very restricted environment? For example, if you are doing some hospital software and there are patient data that cannot be taken outside from the hospital environment. So the only way to do testing with real data is in production environment. So that's one case you might end up doing. And how do you test software that has important data more than one petabyte or even more? So huge amount of data needs to be processed all the time, but the processing might take a month. So how can you test that kind of a process? So basically you cannot copy data from database to another because it takes so long. You cannot test those runs with the software as it takes a month. So there are issues in real life that cannot be experienced in testing environment. And what if there is a specs telling how all the dates in data should be in this standard format, telling that there is a date, then there is a time, and then time zone part. And then in the test environment, everything of course works, but in the production with real data, maybe even one petabyte, not all data is processed. And what is the reason? And the reason turns out to be that there is someone is using in some parts a different date format. So there is a finish time with just one period there between numbers. So these kind of things happens all the time. You get a huge JSON dump of different data, and they should be in same format, but in real life there might be just few cases where the format is not the same. For example, you get pictures of users, and they should be named first name, last name, and then there are few images where it's last name, first name, and then your code cannot comprehend that kind of a data. Cross-device testing. Basically, if you have an Android application and you are describing it so that it should be running with all the Android devices that has Android 8 or newer version. But how can you be sure when there are more than 10,000 different devices and all the Chinese, European, North American, Korean manufacturers can do their own crazy tweaks? So it's impossible to test the app to be 100% sure that it runs on all the devices. With Apple phones or iPads, it's much easier when there are just less than 20 devices available. Then a real life case example. How simple mistake makes things hard. So there is a story how bug was brought to production. So first there was a system that has news items, and all the users that were logged in, they could read the read the news there, and they wanted to, the customer wanted that users were also able to comment on those news items. So comment field was required. And a customer asked very simple comment field. There should be only text field that the user could write some text, and then user's name and commenting timestamp would be taken automatically from the system. And vendor, of course, produced it, customer tested it and accepted it. So what happened next? And here is a picture what was the idea. So you have a comment field and just a button to save that comment. What happened? Users kept posting comments and telling how they are not going through. So they were writing comment and they were pressing save and nothing happened. No comment was found on that news item page. And the reason was that all the comments longer than 256 characters were thrown to recycle bin, and no error messages were shown at all. So it did definitely not work as it was supposed to. And what were the decisions behind this kind of an error? So the backend was built with Drupal, and it was used basically the default text field type, which was short, and it had only 256 characters there, so you could not save longer text there. And customer itself did not specify the length of the field, nor did the vendor ask any specs. So it was just the process was so that they went with the default value. So 256 characters, it's fine. No one is asking anything. No one is specifying anything. So there was no discussion. And then the testing was carried out so that it was only tested to work as it's supposed to. So the tester wrote their test comment and pressed saved, and it worked as it was supposed to. So no breaking had been included in this ad hoc testing. So this was definitely not systematic testing. It was just simple testing with simple few words. So if one could have tested it with longer lorem ipsum copy paste, it would really have had shown the bug. So this testing was not systematic, and there was not enough communication between customer and vendor when it was decided what kind of a field this comment field is going to be. So customer was not known all the backend things, but the vendor also did not ask any real specification for the comment field. And for me, the saddest part in this is that I was responsible for the testing, and I did a horribly bad job. I was not the only one, but I was the one person that should have taken care of this kind of a thing. So in the end, the fix was provided. The field type in the backend was changed, and the counter was brought to frontend to guide users. So now when user wrote a comment, he or she could see that, okay, I have now written 33 characters, and I have still 967 characters left. And this is now much more informative, so now the user can see that he or she cannot write more than 1,000 characters, and it was impossible to write more, and you could not save or even try to save longer a longer comment, so no error in that sense could not error in that sense could not happen. So as I mentioned in the very first video, it is 100 times more costly to fix a bug in a production than in the analysis phase. And this bug was really brought to production. Then it was spent time to trying to figure out what is the reason for this. Then the vendor asked the customer, what is that? What do you really want? And then they implemented that design when the customer provided any new specs. So one could say that money was wasted, although this is not that big. It just took few hours here and there, but it's still something that could not should not have happened. So this is very simple example what could happen in real life if the testing is not carried out as a systematic process, and it is really time to learn from this mistake. At least I hope that I have learned a lot, and please do not repeat my mistakes.